Philippine entertainment industry mourns the death of veteran actress Jacqueline Rose. She was 60. According to her daughter, Andy Agenman, Rose died of a heart attack on the morning of March 2nd. Agenman adds her mother's legacy will continue to live on through her work and family.
I'd just like to say that her undeniable legacy will definitely forever live on through her work, through her children, grandchildren, and the many lives she's touched. As she herself, her life itself was her greatest obra maestra.
For veteran actress and director Bibet Ortesa, Jose will be remembered as a hardworking actress and a caring person.
She operated from the vantage point of someone who knew that she had nothing to lose. Kung ito ang gawin niya, kung decision sa kanyang career. So, from Private Show, her early movies, yung mga ganun niya, she just went on. Kasi, di ba, kumbaga, as they would say, walang keme. Kasi yung people, huwag baka sabihin ng tao, ganito ako. Huwag baka mapintasan ako. Wala siyang ganun. She just went ahead.
Well, President Marcos denies the United States has been influencing the Philippines' foreign policy, notably its actions in the West Philippine Sea. He says Washington is merely reacting to what's happening in the region. He also says the Philippines' foreign policy is grounded on peace. The Philippines and the United States have a mutual defense treaty which requires both nations to support each other if another party attacks the Philippines or the United States.
There is a narrative out there that is going around that we are at the beck and call practically of the United States when it comes to these foreign policy decisions, especially surrounding the South China Sea. But let me make it very, very clear. The Philippines acts for its own interests. And the decisions that we make when it comes to foreign policy are decisions that we make because we believe and are convinced and know that it is in the national interest.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. asserts the Philippines will push back against China if its maritime interests are ignored. He gave those remarks at a Lawi Institute forum in Australia. Marcos said Manila is committed to uphold the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, or UNCLOS, and the 2016 Arbitral Award in the South China Sea. He added his government will do everything in its power to protect the government's sovereignty or the country's sovereignty and maritime jurisdiction.
It is unfortunate that despite the clarity provided by international law, provocative, unilateral, and illegal actions continue to infringe upon our sovereignty, our sovereign rights, our jurisdictions. This pattern of aggression obstructs our path towards ASEAN's vision of the South China Sea as a sea of peace, stability, and of prosperity. We will continue to engage China bilaterally and through ASEAN-led mechanisms to address our differences at sea. We are determined to make our bilateral mechanisms with China work.